I'm like it. It is even the time of Jacob's trouble.
Right.
But he shall be saved out.
The he okay. that shall be saved from it is the elect once again. Because two-thirds gonna be destroyed. Alright? That is why like when we go into them hell, maybe catching hell from this hand, that hand. Guess what? One thing we don't think we might, hey, they're gonna die just now. So we have to know we head for. The Lord gonna judge them just now. Scriptures say, hey, woe to you that mourn, that laugh, for ye shall mourn. Alright? Hey, scripture say be afflicted and mourn. So that is the state we're being right now. How no laughing matter? Alright? How no laughing matter? The time to laugh will come. There's only time to laugh. It's a time of war. It's a time to gird up your loins and gird up your mind.
That's right.
Go ahead. Go ahead.
Verse 8, it says, for it shall come to pass, in that day said Yahweh of hosts, that I will break his yoke from off thy neck.
Yeah, so during that time is the time where we're going to be delivered. So the Lord said, during that time, he's going to break the yoke that the so-called white man have on us. Not the other way around. Not we're going to break the yoke off with our neck. That's what the scripture says, you shall have no might in your hand, and no man shall save you. Because only the Lord gonna deliver us from under the clutches of the devil, which is the so-called white man. You
that's
eat
right. right. That's right.
Alright, and that is your biblical name. You can't run from that name. You so-called white people are Edomites according to the Bible.
That's right.
Alright? Go ahead.
And I will burst thy bonds, and strangers shall no more serve themselves of him.
Yeah, so we ain't gonna go into captivity no more. Alright? Ask us something just now. Yeah, go ahead. And somebody came out Isaiah 24:15.
This is Isaiah chapter 26, verse 20. It says, come, my people, enter thou into thy chambers and shut thy doors about thee.
Yeah, Isaiah 24:14-15. Yes, the Lord say, enter into the chambers. Where's them chambers? Talk about the chariots. All right? When the scriptures say, and that day there shall be a great earthquake, there was, and they ascended into the cloud, and at the same hour was a great earthquake. That great earthquake can be from the missiles. So when they let go up in the so-called UFOs, the chariots, all right, the chariots of the Most High, that when the Lord can say, my people, come up here and enter into the chambers as it were a little while. All right, so we're going to until the indignation pass cross. All right, the scriptures say, only with your eyes you shall behold the destruction of the wicked. All right, the reward of the wicked. All right, you all get front row seats.
That's right. All right.
It's going to be like a drive-in movie. In a vehicle and you're just looking at that great screen. Hey, the scripture says, well, like a sea of glass. And that is how a TV screen is, a big glass. All right, so you're gonna be like a big driving movie, watching America being destroyed.
That's right.
All right, go ahead.
Hide thyself, as it were, for a little moment.
Go ahead.
Until the indignation be overpassed.
Can the indignation talk about the destruction of America. All right, go ahead, Isaiah 24:14-15.
Isaiah chapter 24, verse 14, it says, they shall lift up their voice, they shall sing for the mystery of Yahweh, they shall cry
majesty.
Aloud. The majesty of Yahweh, they shall cry aloud.
Go ahead.
From the sea. Wherefore glorify ye, Lord, in the fires, even the name of Yahweh, power of Israel in the isles of the sea.
Yeah, so guess what? When you read Revelation 15, give me Revelation 15 and 2. What the scriptures say? Scriptures say, hide yourself as it were but for a little moment. Now it's saying they're going to sing majesty unto the Lord. Why are they going to sing majesty unto the Lord? Because they escaped the destruction. All right, the scriptures say the sunny song of Moses. We're going to rejoice, be that we part of our hope in the elect. We're going to rejoice when we see the destruction of the wicked and that we was delivered from that destruction. All right, give me that real quick.
Revelation 15 verse 2. And I saw as it was sea of glass mingled with fire, and them that had gotten the victory over the beast, and over his image, and over his mark,
what?
And over the numbers of his names.
There's the elect out there in the outside the ozone, they are looking down in the chariots of the Most High, so-called UFOs. looking at the destruction, where?
And the numbers over the number of his name stand on the sea of glass, having the harps of power. And they sing the song of Moses, the servant of Yahweh.
Yeah, all right? And the scripture said, it says what? It's, Revelation 11. Give me Revelation 11. 12 to 14. Revelation 11. 12 to 14. Alright? So guess what? They were seeing destruction and they were rejoicing. Because that's going to be the time to rejoice. That's going to be the time to laugh. Somebody give me Proverbs chapter 1. We're going to start at 20. That's going to be the time to rejoice. Now is the time to rejoice. Because guess what? We ain't saved yet. We ain't delivered yet. Alright? The scripture says be afflicted and mourn. Now is the time to mourn. Alright? I've said something just now, Revelation 11.
12 and 12 to 14. It says, this is Revelation chapter 11, verse 12 to 14. It says, and they heard a great voice from heaven, saying unto them, come up hither. And they ascended up to heaven in a cloud, and their enemies beheld them. And the same hour was there a great earthquake.
Yes, so when that destruction come, that same hour was a great earthquake. From the nuclear missiles, Isaiah 34 says what? The earth shall return through like a drunkard. Alright? Said that heaven shall roll together like a scroll. I think it's Isaiah 24:20, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, 24:20.
24:20. Right? But he said the whole earth shall reel to and fro like a drunkard. Whole earth gonna feel that shape from their nuclear missiles.
Huh.
And it's only in that day you people are gonna realize, yeah, shit real.
That's right.
You understand?
That's right.
That day. Bread.
It says, and the 10th part of the city fell.
The 10th part of the city is America. America divided into 10 regions. Bread.
And in the earthquake were slain of men 7,000. And the remnant were frightened and gave glory to the power of heaven.
Yes, to the remnant, when they saw the destruction, they were frightened, but they still gave glory. They still gave glory unto the Lord. All right? They glorified the Lord because why? The scripture says in Revelation 6, how long, will you not judge these people for their dead? So we're looking to see that destruction. All right? Psalm 68 and 20 says the righteous shall rejoice when they see the vengeance. Alright, so we're gonna rejoice when we see all you scoffers, mockers, all you scorners be put to death
by right.
The mighty hands of the Lord.
Good.
Alright? All you Edomites, you so-called East Indians, we're gonna rejoice. All you people rejoicing over us. Alright? We're gonna rejoice over you. Alright? Good.
This is Ecclesiastes chapter 25, verse 7. There be 9 things which I have judged in my heart to be happy, and the 10th will I utter with my tongue. A man that hath joy of his children, and he that liveth to see the fall of his enemy.
Yeah, he that liveth to see the fall of his enemy. And that is what we live to see the downfall of America.
That's right.
Right. Alright? We live to see the downfall of America. Hey, ancient men did that. Ancient men did that. Alright? Yeah. We just used it.
This 20 and 21. Wisdom crieth without, she uttereth her voice in the streets. Verse 21. She crieth in the chief place of concourse, in the openings of the gates, in the city.
I find it. I have it highlighted. There's Tobit chapter 14, verse. I just go straight to the point, verse 15. It says, it's talking about Tobit. Tobias, my bad. It says what? It says, but before he died, he heard of the destruction of Nineveh, which was prophesied by who? By Jonah, the prophet Jonah. right? Which was taken by Nebuchadnezzar and Ahasuerus. And before his death, he rejoiced over Nineveh. So Tobias gloried when he heard that Nineveh was destroyed. All right, so we're going to rejoice when we see that bloody city destroyed.
That's right.
All right, we're going to rejoice. We're going to rejoice to see America be taken down and you wickedly cut out from the face of the earth. All right, go ahead. Not yet.
She cried in the chief place of concourse in the openings of the gate.
Yeah, cried in the agora. All right, in the marketplace, the chief place. Go ahead.
In the city, she uttered a word saying, how long, ye simple ones, will ye love simplicity?
What?
And the scorners delight in their scorning.
Yes, so how long will you people love simplicity? All right, and delight in scorning? Imagine we out here for your sake, but you choose rather to mock than to listen. All right, but hey, Lord went through it. All right? So we glad we're going through, because we glad we're suffering for the Lord's sake.
Right.
Sorry.
Wait.
No. Wait. This is 2 Chronicles 36 and 15. It says, and Yahweh of their father sent to them by his messengers, saying, raise up in be time, right? Because he had compassion on his people and on his dwelling place. But they mocked the messengers of power and despised his words and misused his prophets.
Yes, so when the Lord sent us out there, they despised the Lord's words and they misusing us. And back then they supposed to death. And guess what? If they cannot do it now, they would have done it again. Alright? Because why? They hate the Lord. Alright? Go ahead.
And misused his prophets until the wrath of Yahweh arose against his people.
Yeah, they see the wrath of the Lord arising against them right now. Now I have all these police shootings. I'm going to find the killer on this week. Terrence Kutcher. Alright, and you're going to have much more to come. Alright, the Lord terror turning against you. Somebody give me Jeremiah 10:10 real quick. And then they'll go back to the Proverbs. Jeremiah 10:10 real quick.
And the wrath of Yahweh rose against his people till there was no remedy.
Till there was no remedy. That coming into the time of Jacob's trouble. Go ahead, Jeremiah 10:10.
This is Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 10. It says, but the Lord is the true power. He is the living power and an everlasting king. And his wrath, the earth shall tremble.
Yeah, at his wrath, the earth shall tremble. All right? And the earth do not little shake right now. But in that time of trouble, guess what? The earth really gonna shake.
That's right.
All right? The earth really gonna shake. All right? You people are gonna know true fear in that day. All right? Go ahead.
It says, and the nation shall not be able to abide his indignation.
Yeah, the nation's not gonna be able to abide. And guess what? That ain't talking about all the heathens alone. Somebody give me that in Jeremiah 9. Jeremiah 9, the last two verses, brother.
It's Joel chapter 2. Joel chapter 2 verse 1. It says, blow ye the trumpet in Zion, song and alarm in the holy mountain, that all the inhabitants.
And that is what we're doing right now. We're sounding that alarm. We out here giving that warning.
That's right.
But you people don't want to take heed. Hey, but sure, if it was white, just not tuxedo, not tie, then it would have listened. But the scripture said the poor man's word is despised. But guess what? Noah preached. Noah gave warning, and trust me, it had many deaths. And guess what? The same thing gonna happen again. And,
right.
you know what? You know the sad part? The scripture said, just as in the days of Noah, and you people still ain't taking heed, and the Lord gave only that warning.
This is Hosea chapter 5 and 15. I will go and return to my place. Till they acknowledge their offense.
Well, and we acknowledge your offense right now, and our part of our father's offenses. That is why every day we're begging the Lord for forgiveness, all right, and mercy. Go ahead.
And seek my face. They will seek my face in their affliction. They shall seek me early.
Yeah, we're seeking the Lord early. we now wait till all hell break loose and say, Lord, we believe in you. Before we see any destruction coming, we worship the Lord and we are abiding in the Lord. All right?
Hosea 4 and 6, it says, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge because they rejected knowledge. I will also reject thee, that thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power. I will also forget thee and thy children.
Yeah, you shall also forget thee and thy children. And then what's going to happen to the two-thirds of Israel? Lord, don't forget all that you're dealing with all right now. All right? You're dealing with all on the next side. Right?
This is Jeremiah chapter 9, verse 25 and 26. It says, behold, the days come, saith Yahweh, that I will punish all them which are circumcised with the uncircumcised.
Yes, all them that circumcised. Guess what? Like the men who are in the truth right now, who bullshitting. All right? Who don't want to do the thing that it's supposed to do. Those dry bones that have flesh but have no breath in them. All right? The Lord said he can more or less punish them with the uncircumcised. That is why he said the nation shall not be able to stand at his indignation. All right? So I'm talking about you Israelites too. Right. You two-thirds, you wicked ass two-thirds. What?
It says, Egypt and Judah and Edom and the children of Ammon and Moab and all that are in the utmost corners that dwell in the wilderness. For all these nations are uncircumcised and all the house of Israel are uncircumcised in the heart.
Yeah, so guess what? You people actually waiting for the Lord to come to strong on a couch and call your name by name. Nah, the Lord ain't gonna do nothing like that. All you people don't judge sin to the spirit. Alright? Hey, matter of fact, you judge from the day you was created and the Lord don't know who is his. So the Lord just gonna separate them and all that remain is gonna be destroyed.
God,
right. That the Lord say gonna accept them. Alright? That the Lord, the scriptures say, having their seal. The Lord know them that are his. The Lord point that seal upon the men that sign and sign sincerely. The men that doing this thing of a willing heart.
Sorry.
All right? The men that doing this thing like they have nothing else. All right? Like that's all they have.
God.
All right? The men who love this. All right? The men who love the Lord so much that guess what? That even the actions glorify the Lord. That is the men who the Lord can accept and take away from the destruction. The elect of the house of Israel.
That's right.
Right? Go ahead.
24 says, verily I say unto you, this generation shall pass.
Shall not pass
till all these things be fulfilled.
Yeah, and the Lord wasn't talking about back then because guess what? That generation done dead and gone. But it's that same generation the Lord was talking to that here right now. Alright? You are the same people that was back there right now. That is why watch now when I really think about that, glad the Lord not destroy, you know.
God.
Because there's a lot of all this so that put the Lord upon the cross.
That's
right. Alright? So I glad the Lord gonna take all you out. Alright? Can't wait for that day when the Lord gonna destroy you wicked ass Israelites. Matter of fact, I even call all the Israelites, you wicked ass heathens. Alright? Word.
It says, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall not pass away.
Yeah, so this generation ain't gonna pass. You ain't gonna say, oh, my great grandchildren gonna come and them gonna grow up and the dead Lord ain't gonna come. Trust me. The scripture says, I think it's Ezekiel 12, I think it's 25. It says, in your days shall the destruction come. Alright, Jonathan 37.
Verse 37, it said, but as the days of Noah, where so shall also the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days that were before the flood, they were eating and drinking, marrying and giving in marriage until the day of Noah entered into the ark.
Yes, so it's only until Noah entered into the ark when the floods came, that is when they realized shit real. But guess what? Hey, it's too late. Now the scripture says they shall seek him early.
This is 2 Peter.